in the hole.
Ooh, my turn, Moo. So, you really want to stay tuned for this show right here. We're going to be talking about how the lead arm releases the catapult in your swing in the direction of the target. And so many of you have been told that, you know, you want to try and hit the ball straight, whereas the human machine is a circle-making machine. There are no straight lines in a golf swing, so you should never attempt to try and hit the ball straight. What you want to do is you want to release it in the direction that you want to start the ball and see if it flies straight. Stay tuned. All right, now, tools of the trade. You got one of these hanging around the house. Baseball bat, tennis racket. This is my high school tennis racket, man. You look at this, it's a beauty. An Owen Davidson. You could throw that anywhere you want. It's aluminum, it can't break.
True.
This is a cheap version of a pickleball racket or a ping pong racket or just a plain old household hammer. All of these, it's the same machine, same planet, same rules, but slightly different function of the tool. That's all it is, right? So if I were to say, move here, grab this hammer.
Okay.
And so you're, would you hammer right or left-handed?
I hammer right-handed.
So you're, the dexterity stuff would be with your right hand.
That's it.
Yeah. Cool. All right.
Yeah.
So now if you want to hammer down on this baseball bat,
yeah,
you would go this way, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So since you are a lefty swinger,
yeah,
the baseball bat would be that way.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So now do it with just your right hand on the club, or on the club, on the hammer.
On the hammer, yeah.
Right. So now backswing. Very good. Now after, if I remove the bat,
okay,
and you continue through,
yeah,
what would the hand do? It released, didn't it?
Yeah.
So if we face the camera,
okay,
do that again.
Yeah.
So there's you using momentum,
yeah,
to hammer.
Yeah.
Come on in. Boom. So notice the hand is leading the handle and the handle's leading the hammer perfectly.
Yeah.
So you're collecting the nail here, releasing the nail there.
Yeah.
But after you release the nail,
yeah,
something has to give.
Yeah, it's gotta give.
So yes.
Yeah.
Notice the elbow folds out of the way.
Yeah.
And slings downwards.
Yeah.
And then the hammer is now allowed to release the anatomy of your arm, and then it rehinges, mm-hmm, on that side. It's just gonna rehinge on that snuff box.
Yeah.
But not hit you.
That's it.
Don't impale yourself.
Yeah.
So let me see a nice release.
Yeah.
Face on the camera.
Okay.
Yep. Yes, yeah, very good.
Yeah,
I'm gonna put that in slow motion, okay, and stop action so you see exactly what goes on.
I felt that real, it was real nice.
You felt that release,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah, it was a good reference.
So notice how the weight of the hammer, yeah, is releasing you.
Yeah, I felt that in a
go ahead. Way. Feel that?
Yeah, yeah.
And was, you felt it right out here, didn't you?
Yeah.
And that's what I like about, because you got a little bit of weight here and a little bit of weight there,
yeah,
so you get some good rotational momentum going on in that hammer.
Yeah.
So if I was to play baseball, so I play baseball left-handed.
Okay.
So if I'm hitting a baseball, there's where I'm coming in. There would be impact. There's the ball coming off the bat, but I can't stay that way. Right now, I'm at the end of my range of motion with that wrist.
Yeah.
So now the bat has to start turning. So there's the end of the range of motion, then the bat turns. Notice how as the bat turns,
yeah,
that elbow's got to rotate down.
Yeah.
And the trail hand gets to release over it. So it's like those old TV dials. You're a little young for that.
Yeah.
But when I was a kid, I had to turn the turn the dial. We didn't even have a remote.
Right.
They didn't exist then.
Yeah.
So here I am turning the dial, and you know, I'm a young kid, and some of the dials were a little stiff. So
yeah,
you have to use some leverage.
Yeah.
So there it is, mm-hmm, right? And there's where the release of that lead hand is going to occur.
Yeah.
Now, wasn't that exactly like a topspin backhand release?
Yeah, yeah.
So if I'm doing topspin backhand, notice how the elbow snaps down and it snaps the racket over the top of the ball to give the ball some topspin.
Right.
So now it's the same thing in the golf club. Come on over here with your golf club now.
Okay.
So last week, or just a couple of days ago,
yeah,
we did an amazing video on lag, right? Mm-hmm. So if we get back into that beautiful lag position.
Yeah.
So we're going to the top of the backswing and stop. So the left arm folds, the wrist hinge, and now you're coming back toward the target.
Yeah.
So the arms are falling this way and the club is lagging back here, but it's got nice support with that index finger, right? That trigger finger.
Yeah.
So now the hands are coming through, then the club starts to release.
Yeah.
So as the club starts to release, this G-force has this rotational momentum, and the club is going to pass your hands.
Yeah.
You need to allow that to occur. Now face the camera, do that with the camera here.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
So notice the hands come through first. Then you're starting to get this rotational momentum. Can you feel that?
Yeah.
And then the club has to continue beyond that. So notice how that lead hand has to yield.
Yeah.
Notice how that elbow snaps down out of the way. And see how the back of the hand is facing the ground at that point.
Yeah.
So give it a nice release.
Okay.
So release it toward the target.
Okay.
Beautiful. Didn't that feel like the hammer release?
Yeah, it did.
So if you put your attention on that lead hand, you remember what it felt like when you were releasing the hammer.
Yeah.
And it felt pretty much like the same thing.
Yeah, it did.
Okay. So now that we have this release, I'll let you hit the shot here.
Okay.
What we want is for the ball to be in the way of that release.
Right.
In essence, what's going to happen when the arms are falling, you're going to be collecting the ball from here and releasing the ball into the picture.
Correct.
Without thinking about it.
Right, yeah.
You're just looking for that release over here.
Yeah.
In so doing, when your brain is looking for a release over here, well, the brain's going to go get the ground, use the ground to get your body out of the way so you have access to experience your release over here.
Right.
But if you say, oh, I got to make sure I hit the ball.
Yeah.
There it goes.
Yeah.
So if you were to pull the ball to the right as a righty or as a lefty, I should say.
Yeah.
Or if I'm pulling the ball to the left as a righty or I'm snap hooking it. Mm-hmm. When I snap hook it, it just means that I've released it too soon. Mm-hmm. So many of you are so quick to open the face or weaken your grip because you think you're going to hook the ball.
Yeah, you don't have the
right instead pulse. Of looking for the release in the direction of your target, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So you're going to be hitting a little draw, starting left edge of that intermediate point.
Yeah.
And we're going to go pepper that flag stick up there at 176 with an easy 9-iron. Not bad. Just a little bit right.
Yeah.
Hey, that's why we have a short game, Moo.
Yeah, it was a little toey.
That wasn't too bad, huh?
Yeah.
So did you feel that the release was out there? So there's your proof. Notice you have a 4-degree angle of attack downwards.
Yeah.
Well, that means you were here
coming
down and releasing through.
Yeah.
If you had an upward angle of attack,
correct,
you would have smother hooked that sucker into the trees.
Yeah.
And you would have had an upward angle of attack.
Yeah.
Because you're released too soon.
Yeah, that's
okay?
right.
Okay?
Yeah.
So all we're looking for, if I do the same thing, my eyes are between the leading edge of the club and the ball right now. My eyes are here, but my attention is on that snap release, that yielding snap right out here to the right edge of that intermediate point because I'm hitting a draw. So I'm going to gather that and let it release in that direction. So I could have started that just a little more to the right, but I'm right in the center of the green, taking my two putts back toward that sucker pin at the front.
Right.
The one that suckered you.
Yeah, that's right.
Just kidding.
I got played.
So there's an easy 7-iron right there at 183, and I caught that just a hair thin.
Yeah.
But it was whoosh.
Delivered to the target.
Out there to the target.
Yeah.
So the last drill I wanted to show you, and we saw it in last week's video,
yeah,
or a couple of days ago, is that sword drill, right?
Yeah.
When you're firing that sword, go ahead and do that with your left hand on the club first.
Okay.
Facing the camera, please.
Okay.
There we go. Give it a nice release.
Okay.
So where did you feel the left hand turn over?
Right here.
Right. Yeah. So if the left hand turns over here,
yeah,
what's going to happen to the right hand?
It's going to yield up here.
So it's going to get out of the way.
Yeah.
Yes.
Turn over, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So show me that.
Okay.
Allow it to, like, you're letting the hammer turn over.
Yeah.
There you go. And notice, mm-hmm, you're not letting go of the club.
Yeah, yeah. Got it.
So many of you, when you're coming through, you don't let that release and you're trying to lift the ball and flip it up. Then the club leverages the handle right out of your hands.
Yeah.
You get this big wear spot on your glove.
Right.
It's the whole thing's a nasty situation.
Yeah.
So when you allow it to release, notice you get to stay on the club.
Right.
The club stays in your hands. You get this beautiful compression through impact.
Mm-hmm.
And so you get spin, control, trajectory, all of the good stuff.
Yeah.
All right. So get practicing with your household hammer. Moo just experienced it. You could see it in his eyes and go, hey, I can feel that, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So, and you'll feel it a lot more than a ping pong racket. But if you're a good ping pong player or table tennis player, you know what a good topspin backhand feels like. It's the same for the golf swing. So we're looking for that feel of that release towards the target. And we want to feel like the ball is in the way.
That's right.
So a quick tip on you seeing how the ball is in the way. If I make a practice swing above the ball, so I'm going to go for my release and I'm going to observe the blur of the club as it passes over my ball here. Yes, I felt a really nice release over here and I saw that I missed the ball by about that much. So I get a little lower. Right now, if I go for the same release, it feels like I'm going to top it.
Right.
And if I go a little lower, now it feels like I've got grass, which means I'm cutting the dandelion stem, the ball being the dandelion and the stem like the tee that's underneath it. And it feels like the sole of the club is going to cut through that tee, which means the ball's going to get plastered on the center of that club face if I go for my release. So I got to go for my release, don't I?
Yeah.
So I'm going to focus on letting the weight of the club release me. Boom.
Just explodes off the face.
Explodes off that face right back in the center of the green, same spot where I was. I landed 2 yards away from that same spot. 1 yard, 184. And that's how it works. If you want more detail on predicting contact so that you are allowed to stay with your release towards the target, go to our premium channel, wisdomingolfpremium.com. Check out Predict Contact, the Goldilocks series. That is a major series that you'd never want to miss. And it shows you how the ball position, the distance to ball, the grip club relationship being closed enough, and your levels, which is what I just demonstrated. It'll show you how to match that up so that when you do release in the direction of the target, you feel like you're going to nut it. And you feel like the ball's going to curve in the air the way you want it to curve. Okay? That's how we get to play good golf, because we're able to predict the outcome. And because we're able to predict, we're able to stay with the shot and not have to worry about, oh boy, what if I miss the ball? Or what if I hit it crooked, you know, in the trees again? You don't have to worry about that stuff anymore. You can stick to your task and enjoy the day. All the best. See you next week.